On the back of the gateway, there are two Ethernet ports that correspond directly with the network settings. Network 1 corresponds with Ethernet port 1 and is set to a static IP by default. It can also be set to DHCP. Network 2, which corresponds with Ethernet port 2 on the gateway, by default is set to DHCP, but can also be set to a static IP. If your network does not have DHCP, simply connect to Ethernet port 1 and adjust your computer's IP settings within the range of the gateway's static IP address, which by default is 192.168.41.68, then log into the gateway to modify its settings to fit within your network. Network 1 can also provide DHCP services by enabling DHCP server settings. With this feature enabled, the subnet must be within the range of the gateway IP and a range of IP addresses must be set so it can assign IP addresses. Router is set to the gateway's IP address with a matching DNS-1 address. Some networks may require additional 802.1x security, which you can enable here. Check with your IT department for verification of all network settings. Click Save Settings and it will begin DHCP services. It's important to note that when any network settings are saved with the Save Settings button, the gateway will reboot and you have to log back in. As mentioned earlier, while the gateway is shutting down or rebooting, the ability to control your system will be lost until the gateway is back up. Hosts provides a simple way to connect to AV equipment on the network being controlled by Velocity. Similar to the domain name service, DNS, a domain name can be assigned to a controllable device IP address, making setup easy. Simply provide a domain name assigned to the device and the remote device IP address and save it. To wrap up system settings, let's take a look at the firmware subtab.